Good day, folks. My name's Raymond Moore, and I'm here with the RV Corral in Eugene, Oregon. Nice little city to come and visit if you don't live here already, or my neighbors over in Springfield. I'm here today to tell you a little bit of information on this trade-in that we just took in. It's a 1995. It's a 278 model, which basically doesn't mean anything to you. It's a rear kitchen, and we'll show you that when we go inside. Been around for quite some time. Comes with two propane bottles, which we fill, and they're the newest style. And with this model here, we do have some pass-through storage. The fresh water tank is located above the floor, so we don't have to worry so much about freezing as far as using it in cold weather. I do have a main awning on the outside, as you can visually see. And I do have triple steps going in. This unit here, it looks like the axles have been flopped. What that means is that it's a little higher off the ground, and the springs will sit on top of the axles. We can certainly turn that around and lower it down for you if you wish to do that. Back of the refrigerator, not much to really show you there. Just very, very clean. Spare tire on the back. A little storage on the outside here, maybe an accessory to just a little storage area. Not much there to look at. Bumper in the back. A lot of people will carry their sewer hose back there. And then I do have some crank down stabilizer jacks in the back, and I have power jacks in the front. Somebody has put a slide out topper on this Sportsmaster, which is really nice. In case you're in an area where, for example, that you've got pine cones or tree limbs coming down, a lot easier to let them roll off of that awning than it is to get a ladder up there and actually sweep that area. Nothing really here too much. I got a 6-gallon gas electric hot water heater, so it gives you a little bit more hot water. I have the power switch up in the front for my jacks, and then I have a backup hand crank in case I have some failure. So if you're looking for a nice larger fifth wheel, something maybe under $10,000, this certainly would fit in the budget. And at the end of this movie, folks, we are going to flash up on the screen my name, my email, my phone number. So if you're interested in an older fifth wheel or travel trailer, we can haul it. We do have accessibility to pickup trucks out to a destination place. We can arrange that. So I have a lounge chair immediately to the left when you walk in the door. Place up on the top for a small TV set. The rear kitchen kind of gives you a lot of counter space. Big windows. A nice big gas oven in this particular unit with a microwave up above. I have a double door refrigerator, which is the automatic kind, so it will switch from gas to electric. So if I turn it on right now, it's going to go to automatic gas. If I were to plug it in at 110, it would automatically switch itself to 110, being 110 is the first choice of power. This particular unit is with freestanding table and chairs. And while Curtis is showing you here, one thing with some of these older trailers that I really like is the jalousie windows. I can open a jalousie window here, I can open one in the back, I can get cross ventilation. It doesn't matter if it rains tonight, I'm safe. Security wise, I'm safe, as opposed to the sliding windows where, am I going to leave those open at night? Probably not. Here I have a jackknife sofa, lifts up, pulls down, very easy to make into the second bed. Into the bedroom, I have storage here on the left-hand side. Notice I have three doors. One is going into the bathroom, one is going to the shower, the other one is a storage. Now it gets pretty tight up in this area, so I'm going to let Curtis go up there, hopefully not tripping. He is AKA professional at this. So first we're going to show you the stool and sink area on one side. And we do safety checks on these older fifth wheels, folks, all the time. So you're not buying a pig in a poke. So we'll go over to the other side. And in here, it's going to be closets. So nice closet space. And then, of course, in the front, I have my queen island bed. That looks very comfortable. Could even take a nap in that. I know I can't. Got to keep on working, doing my job. So we do have ducted air conditioning. So that's going to be on a thermostat, just like a home. Here's my control for my slide out over here to make it go in and out. Nice thing about the button being up above, grandkids can't get to it. You know, Grandma, what's this button down here? No, it's up there. So I've done a little show and tell. I hope you enjoyed the video. I have some other older fifth wheels. I have some with two slide outs. So if interested, give me a call, stop by, we'll have a cup of tea. Email me. I email people all the time. I'd love to hear from you. Raymond Moore with the RV Corral in Eugene, Oregon. Eugene's largest RV dealership. Been here over 25 years. Thanks for watching the video, folks, and have a great day.